This is the Retriever Nation presenting Jasmine's Journey with her second litter, Episode 3, Preparing for Whelping. It's 20 below in Minnesota and we are less than 2 weeks from the big day. Jasmine is happy and healthy and growing fast. Just look at her size change. I can tell she's a bit self-conscious of her fuller figure, and so I've been calling her by her favorite nickname, Pretty Pretty, often. Jasmine heard of all the guesses as to how many puppies are in that tummy of hers and has a few replies to those who guessed 12 and 15. But we'll get to that at the end of this episode, where we'll actually get to see puppies kicking and moving in that belly of hers. So where are we in this journey with Jasmine's second litter? Well, having been through this once before, I recognize this as the quiet before the big storm time period. Before I know it, Jasmine will be readying for labor, and as her mama and birth coach, I need to have everything prepared, which is what we'll be talking about today. For us, it all starts with this blue accordion folder. We've saved all our notes from our previous litter and filed them chronologically by stage. It's been tremendously helpful because it contains the pertinent information we will need as we go through the rapidly changing milestones of having a litter. My tabs are labeled breeding, pregnancy, whelping and whelping emergencies, weighing and charting, ENS, weaning and sound desensitization, and preparing the puppies to go. But the very front tab is labeled improvements for next time, and I'm really glad we wrote notes on this just following our last litter because I'd already forgotten most of the items we wanted to tweak for improvement. I've been referring to this weekly and we'll keep it handy because once those cute little puppies come, we'll be moving through the milestones at an unbelievable rate. Remember, it's only 7 weeks from birth that they are placed into the arms of their new family, and that time will be here before we know it. The next preparation to be made for the upcoming litter is determining the whelping location and setting up the whelping box. Probably the most important consideration of whelping a litter is the location. Temperature and space are big considerations here. Puppies need to be kept warm and can easily die, especially in the first few days if it gets too cold. Our last litter was whelped in the basement. Despite it being winter in Minnesota, we were able to keep our basement snugly warm with a fireplace, and the larger open space worked out perfectly as they grew. We only have our puppies in the whelping box for about the first 3 weeks. Now that we've determined location, let's discuss the whelping box itself. Jeff built this whelping box for our last litter, so this time we just needed to reassemble it. I read in my notes labeled improvements for next time to shorten the height of the walls. We learned that they really didn't need to be so tall, and this modification will make reaching inside and cleaning much easier. Jeff measured twice and cut once and had this change done in no time. The basic construction is a platform with a center hole to hold the heating basin, 4 walls, one with an entry point for Jasmine, and the PVC pig rail, which saves the tiny puppies from being squished. For my coworkers in the healthcare field that may not understand that, I'll show you exactly how this works once the puppies come. Both Jasmine and Poppet check on the progress and give Jeff their approval. Another modification Jeff made this time was the addition of temporary 1x4 posts. This was done so we can drape a large blanket over the top to resemble a fort or a cave. Hours prior to Jasmine's last delivery, she had an incredibly strong urge to crawl under one of the beds downstairs. Despite there being boxes and totes under the bed, she somehow managed to work her way deep under it against the wall, and we'd have to work really hard at getting her out. It must be a maternal protective instinct. After having this happen a few times despite efforts to stop her, Jeff came up with a brilliant idea of throwing a blanket over the whelping box to make it like a cave. It worked like a charm. Jasmine felt safe and secure. As the puppy started coming, we were able to remove the blanket without it affecting her, as she was a little preoccupied. So as I've been showing you the whelping box, you may have noticed the bare floors. Well, after 86 inches of winter snow and then 40 inches of spring rains, our basement flooded for the first time, and then the second, and the third, and the fourth. We had major work done, and the basement is now clean and very dry, with most repairs finished but the flooring. We've decided to wait a season before putting flooring down to make sure our new system for routing water works. This bare floor is an issue we need to address for when the puppies move out of the whelping box. It's imperative the floor is not cold. We've purchased 1.5-inch sheets of insulation with high R rating to put down. We've also bought vinyl remnant pieces from Menards to lay over the insulation. This solution, along with running the gas fireplace, should be plenty warm for the puppies. But rest assured, we'll be making sure our fix to the issue works well and modify quickly if need be.
With our well-being area prepared and ready for the big day, I want to take a minute to tell you of the favorite products we've used for Jasmine's health. Of course, it all starts with a premium dog food, and we use Nutrisource Performance. At 30% protein and 20% fat, it has the high protein percentage she needs for training as well as whelping a litter. It's also loaded with terrific ingredients like omega-6 and 3 fatty acids, glucosamine and chondroitin, and probiotics. Not all performance dog foods can say that. In addition to her food, I always have all of my dogs on Phytovite Sports Dog Powder Supplement. It has high levels of omega-3s, contains glucosamine and chondroitin for joint health, as well as yuca, which, when paired with the DHA, help with inflammation. Important to me, though, is the ingredient coconut oil, which enhances the ability of muscles to utilize energy. And just as important are the added prebiotics and probiotics for gut health. The iron, copper, and nucleotides in it help to keep red blood cells healthy, and we know more oxygen to the brain means better focus. I just can't say enough about this product and will never go without it. That's how much I believe in it. So this is our 1-2 punch for nutrition, and I promise you 1 month on this combo and you will notice a difference in the overall appearance, shiny coat, and improved health of your dog. However, Jasmine has been getting one additional treat in her daily food. Breeder's Edge Oxymate Prenatal Formula is a product designed specifically for expectant mamas. It's the equivalent of a prenatal vitamin and gives her the additional nutritional support needed to grow healthy puppies and carry her through delivery in excellent health. Oxymate is the most complete prenatal supplement I've found. But once Jasmine delivers, we will switch to Breeder's Edge OxyMama. The nursing and recovery formula will give her the unique vitamin and mineral support needed for the demands of feeding a litter. It helps lactating mamas produce more milk and helps them to recover from whelping quickly. I strongly believe it starts with good nutrition and supplementation with vitamins and minerals. I have to say that my current vitamin D levels feel at an all-time low. I'm sure my friends in the North can relate. I may have to do something about that soon. Well, we've covered the basic preparations and nutrition, so let's check back in on the soon-to-be mama, Jazzy. I can tell Jasmine is having a difficult time getting comfortable. The days are literally numbered. We are in the single-digit countdown. Just look at that big tummy. It's so tight. Jeff and I have been able to feel little puppies moving and kicking. Let's just watch for a moment. Oh, I'm madly in love with all of them already. But how many are there? Y'all agreed with me that there are more than 5 puppies in there, with guesses ranging from 7 to 15. Jasmine told me the high guesses of 12 and 15 were just ridiculous, and she doesn't even have that many boobies. But she did agree all the other guesses were in the ballpark. And speaking of ballpark, I was able to squeeze in a trip to the sunny state of Florida with my dad. The trip had been planned for months prior to knowing that a litter would be coming. You can be sure I left Jeff with all kinds of instructions and what to watch for just in case Jazzy decided to have puppies early while I was away. I called daily to check in on her well-being and had Jeff send me pictures of her so I could connect from afar. You may recall she's extremely bonded to me. After replenishing my vitamin D levels through days of watching waves crash and taking in 3 ball games, I returned to the North just in time for the x-ray that will give us the precise count of puppies that are in that tight tummy. In just days, we'll see how close your guess was. Was it a swing and a miss, or did you knock it out of the ballpark? If you're one of the few who hasn't guessed yet, this is your last chance to do so. Send us your guess in the comments below or in the Facebook link to this video. And then be sure to subscribe to our channel and follow us on Instagram so you can not only hear who guessed correctly, but also see the x-ray and count skulls and spines with me. And as always, if you want to join Jasmine's fan club, hit on the like button below. Until next time, this is Terry with The Retriever Nation.